these poison spitters aren't evil, just misunderstood
sex workers?
Because
I do remember
that. Probably.
Because isn't it... Wasn't there like an issue with shop keeps if you're hollow? Oh my god, game.
No issues.
No? Huh. So what were you saving humanity for that whole time?
When you basically in your inventory, it's useless, but once you use it, you increase the number in the top left.
Oh, yeah.
And that also, for every humanity you have, it increases your item find percentage. Which is the chance for enemies to drop loot.
And I can kindle fires.
Precisely.
But I keep dying. I don't want to lose humanity.
That's the problem.
Oh, this guy was on the ball this time.
That's why I said, until later in the game when you can just farm it,
just...
it's really worth just stashing. Been dealing with having, I think, a quarter less HP.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God.
Or is it half in Dark Souls 1?
Soft humanity? I don't... I didn't know there was such a thing as soft humanity. Of course, I went in not knowing anything, really. Except C for my name. And that he's gonna be really... He's gonna be a huge bitch to farm the sword for. Oh yeah, that guy. Oh, okay. Apparently it's not until Dark Souls 2 that your health will decrease if you're hollow.
Okay, there's other penalties to being hollow.
Yeah. Damn it. These clever butts. Oops. You know what? I'm cool with you canceling that. I am risking everything. I know, Pep. I gotta clear these guys first.
Oh, is that it's bedtime, 9 o'clock alarm?
I think it is. It is 9 o'clock. He's only 3 minutes off.
Well, I can go on break real quick and put him to bed for you.
You sure?
Because your game doesn't pause. Mine does.
Well, I'm in a safe spot. I'm kind of remembering the layout of the enemies here.
It's up to you. Which do you want to do it or me do it?
As long as Pepper won't feel betrayed, maybe you can put him to bed for, you know, mix it up for
him. Say it like that.
Well, it's just sometimes birds get stuck in a very heavy routine and they're gonna make a fit just because, oh, it was supposed to be Mama Bird who tucked me in, not you.
True. But I'll do it anyway for you.
Yeah.
I'll be right back.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden these guys are more aggressive and they're not playing shield. Oh! Okay. Really? No multiplayer while I'm hollow? Interesting. Which, really, I'm okay with that, I guess. Is it just in this game, or...
In general.
In general, being hollow, people aren't gonna invade you?
They can't.
Huh. That's weird, though, because I'm gonna be hollow all the freaking time. Oh, he's the more defensive.
Put a thing on my stream so I'm getting hurt to bed.
There you go.
Are you ready for bed? Are you ready for bed?
Oh, come on. Your health is almost gone. Yeah.
Good night.
Good bird. Sleep well, Pepper Bird.
Let's get you to bed.
Still gonna head to the boss with 3. Whoa. Oh, dang it. I got backstabbed. Yeah. Well, it sucks that I'm with 1 again, but might as well press forward, because otherwise I gotta go through all of them again. Might as well practice to get better against beautiful, beautiful calves. Taurus. I still want Seed's greatsword, cause then Anthony will be proud of me, I bet. One, it's really hard to get. Two, he's playing Kingsfield in the back. Oi! Oi, bro! Bro! I am... Oh, I forgot about the dudes on the... Forgot about those one dudes. And now I'm gonna get... Wow, it's like I didn't heal at all. Well, I'm just gonna take the damage, because, I mean, you know, that. Unless I have something.
You died at the beginning?
Well, I forgot about the dudes on top of the tower.
Oh, so you got sniped.
Yeah, so I was like, you know, I only have one flask. I might as well just reset. Screw it.
Nice.
Dang it. Dang it.
Alright, I am back.
Oh, come on, you're not on the ball this time. Wake up, bro.
Also, hello, Grasshopper Sage. How are you doing?
But yes, Anthony, do you agree with my trail of thought that even if the Moonlight Greatsword isn't the strongest weapon I can get in this game, I should still do it in your name?
Nah. Although it is one of the strongest weapons in the game.
I've got a comment from...
She's like, even if it's not the greatest,
well,
it actually
that's...
is, because it does about 1,000 damage a hit against most enemies that do not resist magic.
Oh, that's where the catch is.
Because the weapon does pure magic damage, which means even if they block, you do almost full damage to them. But not many enemies in Dark Souls 1 resist magic.
Oh, do they don't or do?
Magic in Dark Souls 1 is the most broken thing in the game.
Okay.
Basically, playing a mage is playing easy mode.
Yeah. And see, he... Wait. No, he doesn't notice. Wait, nope, there he is. Now he notices me.
So, mages in Dark Souls will usually one-shot you, even in PvP.
Jesus.
All they have to do is line up and you're dead in one hit because they can do about 1,000 damage really, really fast.
That's rude.
No, that's just their build.
I know.
They don't have to, all they care about is one stat. Intellect. And basically, the way spells scale is they scale super well with just intellect. There's no needing, like, dex and strength, because most melee weapons scale with a little bit of dex and a lot of either strength, or a lot of dex and a lot of strength.
But yeah, so, from Anthony, the reason why Skulker said they don't, that it's not that good is just because of that little asterisk next to the sword. It's really, really good if the enemy doesn't resist magic.
Yep.
So that's where their stance on it came from. Also, I aggro both of them again, so...
But my favorite weapon in Dark Souls has to be the blue sword. Or the blue fire sword, whatever it is. The sword that is basically just a standard long sword, but my heavy attack casts my equipped spell instead of doing like a standard long sword attack. Because it's super cheesy. Against PvPers, because you go into combat and if they don't recognize it as the blue fire sword or whatever it is, you just like kind of
Oh, there we go. Alright! You showed up too.
Right! Oh, you're blocking all my R1s? Here, just eat my most powerful spell in your face. But I would also combo it with the...
Well, that didn't work out.
...spell greatsword. So the sorcery had a greatsword version that basically just... If you know, what ability is it? Beamblade for Cloud in Final Fantasy VII.
You're being
when
sassed.
You attack a giant energy blade. It's basically that as a spell.
You're being sassed out, Anthony.
Of course I'm being sassed out.
That everyone can dodge the Greatsword R2 in PvP.
Oh, really? Everyone can dodge it? I want to see this happen.
I like that. Please just fight me. And I'm like, I'm the one playing the game right now.
I will level up my build. Huh? Yeah, right? Everyone's gonna diss the Moonlight Greatsword because it's super easy to defeat. It's like, yeah, the The problem is that if you are able to predict it, they're not being unpredictable enough in PvP.
I don't want PvP! Look at me die to the same enemies!
Because a lot of the weapons in Dark Souls 1, a lot of weapons in general, are predictable. And the goal of PvP is to be as unpredictable as possible, so that way you can just go, okay.
Like the one guy in Dark Souls 3 who just used the emoticon to lay down, and his armor blended with the stone flooring.
Yeah. And then he walked up behind the guy and killed him afterwards. Precisely.
That's so great, because the guy who invaded him is just like, what the... What?
Or like what my brother and I do is we both have the item that turns us into random objects from the scenery.
And then you play prop hunt with them?
Yeah, you play prop hunt, and then or what you do is I hide as one, my brother is the guy that is invaded, so he goes and finds my brother, and then my brother just like, oh, lets himself get low, whittles the guy down to half at the same time, and then I show up, backstab, and he lives.
That's so great.
Because it's fun to be a dick in Dark Souls.
That's kind of what it teaches
especially
you.
Especially when there's an item that forces people to...
I've never done that before! That was so satisfying!
Because there's an item that forces people to invade you. So you can just get you and like two other friends, and just be like, oh yeah, we're gonna be a dick now. And then you just trick people into showing up.
Hooray, good to see that collision protection on the ladders hasn't been hurt. I don't know if I should use my flask yet.
Are you still fighting him?
Yes. I messed up, okay? I messed up. I almost beat him, and I messed up.
I don't know, I can sense a little bit of the sass coming out strong in her. I was just asking a legit question, like, and she's like, I fucked up. I was like, how are you just asking a simple question if you're still on the same boss?
Because you have a way of, like, just sounding sassy even when you're just intending to, like... I can't cover that, because I...
Precisely, that's the thing. I don't have money. The only source of money I have...
Whoops. That was just me flat out speaking. Huh? What's up, Anthony? That is... Where am I? Okay. Don't stop fighting until you die. Doo-ba-doo. Oh god, I suck all of a sudden.
Did I?
Am I spacing out again? This is not cool. I would like to stream for more than like an hour and a half game.
Sorry.
That was just me being sloppy. Like, that was all on me. my wrist.
Hopefully we'll get some better weaponry soon.
I think I definitely need to switch to a PlayStation controller.
You want my other... Oh, you don't have the PS4 controller set up?
No, I don't.
We'll set that up for your next stream.
Yeah. It might help me, but I may just not hold a control very well. Or I screwed up...
You put
up
the controller above on your desk?
Huh?
Or you just let it rest in your lap?
In my lap. Who knows? I mean, I've also...
How tight are you gripping that damn controller then?
I could have controller death grip and not notice.
I am very paranoid about my controller death grip, where I just, like, gingerly...
No! Well, I try to be ginger about it, but...
Because I've... Google it. It's a horror game. Oh,
why?
Death grip and see what some people do to their controllers.
It's amazing. I'm gonna have to look in this corner. Oh, come on!
Here.
Come on, let me get to the boss with 4 flasks. Just let me be good enough for that.
Really? Because I put in 4.
What's your face? Get over here. Yo. You're on the slow train today. Who's on the slower train, though, is the question. Me or you? Is that even worth my time?
Aw, I'm not gonna fight any ages.
Why not?
Is it just... No one is videotaped. What happens to their...
Oh, not... What about a photo, though? Oh, well, what a surprise.
Basically, some people have, like, just horrendously, like, fucked up their controllers. Like, you'll see some controllers that are, like, at a 90-degree angle from, like, how they're supposed to be.
This is, like, barely any different.
Because people have death grip while they're playing a game because they get so tense.
It's like, probably why my hands hurt after Isaac for like a couple hours.
Yeah, some people have that with their controllers, and you'll find some people have actually, if they have enough strength, have like warped the fork. And permanently modified the shape of the controller.
I mean, when we're babies, we have inhuman strength. Also,
with Xbox, people have actually shattered, you know, the little palm rests in their hand. Because of how hard that plastic is, once you shatter it, it just makes something like slices your hand.
Ow. Woo! And gotcha.
Some people are paranoid over it because death grip is a legit issue that people
have. It is, unfortunately, very legit.
No, it's not just nerd rage. It's just, it's not even rage-inducing. It's the fact that you get so into it, you could, or you're in, sometimes it's in pain, like when you're getting a tattoo or something and you grip the chair. But for video games, sometimes you just get so into it and you're like mashing buttons sometimes that you don't realize the rest of your hand is tightening around your controller.
He's doing this dance again, come on, man.
Until, you know, it's too late and you've destroyed the controller.
Just let him do the dance. I will keep that in mind next time. Just let him do the dance.
Board of shadow ones.
Oh! There! Finally.
Yep, and your input had to be precise or you'd accidentally fall off a cliff.
I am randomly feeling sleepy, and I actually slept
in
today.
Yeah, it kills your hand too while you're at it.
But then again, I also walked a lot today. Because Anthony's family took him to see... Damn it. Took him to see Star Wars again. And I was like, look, I like Rogue One, but I don't want to see it three times within 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. So...
That's why they invented the fight stick.
Yeah, I just spent... like 2 hours
really
just walking through a shopping center, so that's probably where my sleepiness is coming from. Alright, I can totally fight him now!
Takes 2 minutes.
Once again, at least I can grab those souls before he spawns. I've got the strategy down. I just gotta time it. And control the camera. Just because I have the strategy down doesn't mean I necessarily master it. No, hey, dude.
What are you downloading?
There you go.
Dreamfall? Okay.
Mary!
The new walking one?
I guess I should have run towards him instead. I wasn't sure which way to go. I was doing some great before.
I see a lot of broken ones. Speak of the devil, I said I'm gonna find a sword in here.
Come on.
I could totally
beat this guy tonight. Come on.
If only all the enemies weren't.
Speedrun this shit.
Scale.
Oh! There
it is.
Alright, how's it going, buddy?
Because the game's
still
like,
better
oh,
than grinding for a ditto with a modest nature. And it'll go through the same enemies.
Actually now making them flinch when I hit them.
Uh-oh, I've been tagged in a post on Facebook. It's probably bird-related.
Yeah, what?
Your mom tagged me in a post. And it's gotta be birds. That's usually what people tag me for.
Yep.
Which I appreciate, but I'm just like, uh-oh. I'm in the middle of a stream, and now I have the temptation to see if there's a bird video.
No. You don't need to see the bird videos.
I did it last night.
I know, you stopped midstream to look at bird videos, and you were too tired after adorable bird videos.
No. I was hiding that I was tired before then. Oh, shut up. It was cuteness overload, okay? You remember my face after I watched Piper?
Oh, you mean the tears of joy?
The tears of joy.
Alright, we're going to talk to Marilyn again.
And then thanks Finding Dory was nowhere near as awesome as Piper.
I don't need it anymore now that he's safe. I'll pray for your safety, Lyle, and your victory, too.
I almost had that. Down to
I have a friend named
art.
James Stewart McCain V, who is waiting for Commander Silveria to
return. We're at 5 so far.
If you ever happen to see him, please
just get pissed at the game and say, I will persevere.
I'd like to return to my house. I had a beautiful view of the ocean.
Let's see how much stronger the black one is. Roasting toast. Yes.
To appear, the town was covered in a deep snow.
Oh,
the beach began to drop off and all right,
come dance.
An ugly cliff
come on over.
A beautiful beach.
Come on. Yeah, yeah, make your dead friend do the splits over
many
there.
Many people used to come to visit there. The
five,
was
five
gorgeous.
Flats.
We're all so very proud of our beautiful
psych.
Country.
I'm out of here.
On a clear day, you could see the island of
Roland
Ant.
Wait, then there's that one
you couldn't describe the beauty with words.
Ah, oh,
day,
I thought that was
been nothing
the
but
enemy.
Dark, gray, and gloomy.
I guess I have to fight him.
Would return. I used to play on the beach as a child.
Yeah, oh great, I aggroed the other one because I'm a genius.
Water from far off land.
Let's use a regular
like
firebomb.
I'm sorry to bore you with an old woman's memories, but I feel like you're part of my family.
Yeah, long sword.
Please come again soon.
Okay, now I can run. Take that, sucker.
Hey, God's House, how are you doing?
Five flasks of progress.
Hope your evening is going good. We're just here playing through some Kingsfield.
I know.
Get moved so we can go grab a plant now.
Getting slightly gooder.
Runestone. Vice Commander Kane, forever we shall lift up your flame. And there's a sword. And that is better than the Morning Star because fire magic does do extra damage to skeletons, I think. At least it would make sense if it did.
Dang it. I think the boss is going to spawn for this one.
I hear you're planning to go to the castle. In that case, I suggest you stop your mother's tomb.
Go ahead and have some fun there. I want my 4K souls.
That castle is suicide.
Towards him! There we go.
Glad you're going to again. Keep skipping the shopkeeper text. Maybe you can stay alive.
Come on! There we
that's
go.
That's the problem with the others. They either disappear or die.
Oops. Drink it! Dodge it! Ah!
I've dug hundreds of graves. I don't want to dig one for you. I hope I don't have to dig one for Commander Silveria either.
I realize I didn't quite plan that, did I?
Here's some free advice, although they missed
the best
from a guy who's been around. If you don't know him already,
oh, that was close.
There are many creatures here that carry poison.
You know what? It's better than falling off the edge. Wrong one! That was me mashing the wrong button. As long as I progress a little bit more than the previous death.
My collections are very
that's
expensive.
A good sign.
If you see anything
just
you like,
a little
bring
bit,
it over here.
You know?
I'll make you a deal. The very best items usually find their way to my collection. That's why he's got two really good items right here. Like, the 60,000 one is because I think it just casts Fireball for free.
I have
and
two
then
levels
also got,
of ups, man.
Crystal flasks
but,
that I can buy.
If I can just...
Although they're expensive, they're well worth it. Yeah!
If I could just get it.
That was the game's hint at go visit your mom's tomb. I've unlocked the door and all the chests in there. So you can.
That dude always likes to hang around, doesn't he?
So now we can go back and use the two chests that were unlocked. is.
I love how this note just floats randomly.
And it wouldn't be a bad idea to go sell gear that I no longer need as well. At the merchant. So we're just gonna quickly run back to town. But in this game,
you're supposed to be doing
just involved a lot of like backtracking, talking to townspeople, figuring out where they want you to go next, or they hinted places to go next. They don't really tell you, hey, you should probably check this out. They just go, oh, it used to be this one area that
dang it.
Go do this in. Oh, cool, so I have to go find that now.
Oh, I think we friendly fire at him. Sweet. And that was just
a mechanic, if you wanted hints on where to go, you just talk to villagers as you came across them.
Let's get you guys all the way over
and
here.
They also give you tips on items for
dang
how
it.
They can be used.
That wasn't the best idea I had. So long, loser!
And this is the team of our mother.
Let me through! I did it! Getting up there.
Money. Truth glass is only ever worth money.
And we're safe.
The doves use it so it tells you the name of a place you're in, but you never really need to know what place you're in, the name of it. So you can just sell it most of the time for money. So you'll see that before, when I hit a skeleton, they wouldn't glow red when they walked. The reason is because flame does some fire magic damage, and blocking does not protect from magic completely. Yay, our first crystal flask. And unlike Kingsfield 1, I can't buy keys in this. I have to manually find them.
Try this again.
Which can be kind of a pain in the ass. And it's like, oh, I got a crystal flask, and you just go over to there, but you notice there's no water pouring out of it. Those are the fountains of this game.
Come on, let's dance, man.
Oh,
that was not the best timing. Move it. Buttons are going to be the death of me
now. I guess you need to be really careful with this. The game, I think, lets you sell stuff you've got. Yes.
Stimpy stamp.
All the map of our diets tell you which area you're in zone-wise, so we just sell it. It's also faster to individually press this than to just hold the button down.
I kind of dodged that. Come on over.
Not really.
It's easier to dodge roll when you're jumping. At least
the
I didn't take any damage.
The other important thing about money is you can use it as an inn to restore your MP and health, and it also passes time.
It's really, really hard to dodge that.
So,
okay.
When I was doing Kingsfield 2, Kingsfield 1 finds time, I ran into an issue where Leon did not give me the ultimate weapon in the game because I can't pass the game with Bristol. So, like, I need more time. He's going to do the same thing later in the game. I can just go rest at the inn until he's finally ready. Yeah, this is kind of like...
Yeah. I felt like I had to rush this boss, and I don't. Keep going, keep going. Scoot! Last flask.
Like, I could go through that door, and it would take me really quickly to where I would go. I don't want to do that. I have to walk all the way around.
Uh-oh, sure, shit. Ah!
But we'll just sell the Edward quick back.
Ow! Him and his feet!
So, we're back that way, but I just realized, I just want to move backwards, grab the feet, and move back around this way, and walk with the backtrack.
Come on. Nearly gotcha. And finish him off! Woo! Woo! Victory achieved!
Oh well, I'll have it at midnight.
Homeward bound. Look at all those souls! Should I wait until I can see a merchant? Maybe there's a merchant. I know, I can go a whole 2 levels right now.
Oh.
What?
I thought it was like more than that.
No. I love when I can break barrels.
These kind of lock us out of rooms. So they kind of force you to do this because otherwise you're not going to have enough keys in the first place. Was there another door? It must have just been one door.
Although I do have a lot of lost undead souls.
You would?
I do have a few lost undead souls I could just, you know, use. Oh, there's one of those knight dudes, right?
No.
No?
That's Buddy.
That's Buddy. Oh, it is Buddy, isn't it? Sorry, you were so big.
She's just not ready to kill Solera, right?
Yeah, I know. I'm like, wait a minute, I should have rotated the camera.
I am for my girlfriend. It's just, oh, hey, a knight, kill it.
Well, now that I am undead, I don't know.
I have come to this place. Sorry, that's what most people did, I'm sure, on their first playthrough, thinking he was one of the evil knights.
Will he attack you if you hurt him?
Oh, yeah.
I imagine.
And then he'll impale you on a spear of lightning.
Oh, shit.
I get that look all the time.
Okay.
Didn't I say it was?
Let's just admire the sun together.
Oh. Aha. So I didn't scare you. I have a proposition, if you have a moment.
No, don't say no!
Yes, quite understandable.
Controller lag.
I'm actually gonna refill here on the healing water.
We'll laugh it off, shall we?
Oh no, Slayer. Slayer, it's okay. It's okay. I button mashed.
Oh, hello. You're still
through some water.
You look...
I'm not too worried about saving.
Are you okay?
Really hard
that does not
dying.
Look comfortable.
I mean, like, it's common, but I do have a dragon plant on me. Alright, they call it dragon plant in this one, but they still call it dragon crystal. I have a dragon crystal which will resurrect me back at the beginning of the game.
So what do you say? Why not help one another on this lonely journey?
The game kind of takes it easy on you
but
using one free chance.
It pleases me greatly. Well then, take this. We are amidst strange beings in a strange land. The flow of time itself is convoluted, with heroes centuries old phasing in and out.
PvP
preference. And relations shift and obscure. There's no telling how much longer your world and mine will remain in contact.
These are basically the game's loading zones.
Summon one another.
They make you walk through them, so that way it kind of makes it feel...
And engage.
Oh, I'm just stuck in a loading screen. Like, they could have removed these and had a loading screen and it would have been just fine.
But I am a warrior of
but
the sun.
But they didn't need a loading screen.
But my summon
I kind of like that there isn't.
By its brilliant aura. If you miss it, you must be blind.
So I grab the bow early.
Well, thanks, Vansilaire.
So I'm gonna have a skeleton end up dropping behind me, so I'm gonna turn around. There's a skeleton. Because the game got a lot better between 1 and 2.
Oh, boy.
Having things hide in the ceiling. And with respawning enemies, without having, like, no bonfire, it's just constantly respawning.
Thanks. Oh, that's definitely why we praise the sun. Stupid dragon! I even remember you when I was watching him.
That's not a dragon. It's only a drake.
That sucks even more. No! Do I have to fight what's-his-face again?
Boss, no.
Okay.
But you still gotta walk all the way over there again.
And I might die in one hit trying to retrieve my souls, even if it was just 2 level ups. I won them.
You wanna know something that'll make things a lot easier?
Yeah.
How much you need to get out of here?
Like 5.
Alright, go use 2 of them.
Why?
Because you can actually kindle without using this thing right away. But you can only kindle once, and that'll be 10 flasks.
Yeah, that's true.
I always kindle every bonfire I come to at least have 10 items at it, so I'm not digging around with just 5. I've been living here for over 5 years now. When the commander headed for the castle, I had to remain here alone because I was wounded. Do you have any idea what it means to a soldier to be left behind?
Just keep on. And sudden Drake. Like, they totally set that up for new players to not even know.
After my field, I began to speak grave for my fallen comrades. But I've been waiting for the commander's return for over 5 years now.
That was very cleverly done.
I'd just be granted the death I deserved so long ago. In these underground barracks, Commander Silveria made several traps for training purposes. Not much time for training, I'm afraid. Most of the soldiers died before they ever even knew about the training or the traps.
That's
in
what I kept
jail,
telling
you
to do.
All
you
have
no.
to do is pull back the boat and
to be honest, though, I think it's best that I was saving the humanity when trying to learn the boss.
They made poor fighting men, but they all loved Silveria.
Like, that's the thing. I knew I was gonna die super, super fast.
I remember saying something about setting a trap for the commander's sword. It was a trap to test the next recipient, so that anyone smart enough and strong enough to figure out the trap could
have. Oh, I could have.
Silverian was another of the commander's swords.
Do I have enough healing? No, I don't. I'm so pretty damn old. Also, let's make things easier on myself.
I believe the sword was given to the commander by another commander, Lord Baron. Swordmaster Howard.
Oh, well, I mean,
I
can always just access that.
Our commander was a brave warrior with a special ability to devise complicated traps.
So, is there a way I can...
Captain's room.
Levers and blah 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 blah. Is there a way I can
yes,
check that? Do I just have to stare at my face and that's how I know when I'm
What's
back
up?
To being? You
oh,
said
the guy's
you should.
Chops are rotting. Yeah.
But why?
He's got some nice chops.
Well, I can level up at least. I think. No, no, I can't. I don't have enough. That's fine.
Yeah, bow height.
Still hollowed. I am hollowed out the ass.
Yeah, most people don't even know this is here.
Oh, damn it.
Find the jail key.
Damn it.
It's like, I'll just grab it.
No wonder. I'm a slow butt. You know what? That's fine. I had to do that.
It's on this course.
I had to learn.
Because otherwise you have to wait a long
I had
time
to learn,
to
man. That was
that needs
the best way
away.
To burn through all of that. Okay. Okay. Oh, gotcha. We're fine.
I love how the game feels like it's got this pixely filter on it, like a noise filter. But that's literally... just what they use to make a wood texture was literally just a noise, probably a noise filter in Photoshop.
Oops, I forgot. He ain't done yet.
Wood.
Oh, there he is.
Dithering? Yeah, probably that too. I also know my
actually, I was misreading the step in the top left because
the
short-term memory kicked in.
Well.
So, maybe I can level up more than I thought I could. Maybe at least
three.
Well,
I really want to know is why did they differ so much?
Damn it. Clever
butts. Yeah, I could see it being a lazy thing, but at the same time, you have to realize how massive this game is. Like, this game is freaking massive scope-wise.
Come on. There we go.
For, like, hallways like this, yeah. Alright, let's do the prison.
Oh wow, didn't quite finish him off because I accidentally did that attack.
These are supposed to, I guess,
be
carved prison walls?
The soothing sounds of explosions.
Which to me I just find.
Damn it.
That's odd. Alright, where's the ghost in the hallway? I know he's here. There he is.
Just burn through its blast.
There's usually a second one.
Oh, I got both of them again.
Huh. In one of these rooms is the bow. I think it's this one. So I think it's over there on the ground.
Bugs. No! Excuse me.
Is that your parents?
Nope. Vinny. Is live.
Of course.
Of course he is. And
don't you just love when, like, one of your favorite streamers goes live while you're streaming? It's like...
Yeah, and he's playing Isaac. So, you know, that's just a double stab.
Oh, well, that's what YouTube is for.
Yeah, exactly. He usually, like, he creates reels of his, like, favorite moments in certain streams. Also, he archives the entire stream, so, you know.
Well, that's nice.
I should probably... just have those as background noise sometime. If I'm sick of listening to what Pandora
has to say.
Yeah. It still thinks all I want to listen to is Skrillex and Deadmau5. I'm like, dude, dubstep is a whole genre, not two people. Come on now.
Yeah, but because they do much of the stuff with dubstep.
Yeah, they're pretty much considered the labels. You know, they're the... What's the proper phrase? They're...
the popular ones.
They're the figureheads.
Yeah.
So, yeah. It also doesn't help that I thumbs up a lot, like, specific ones, specific tracks, and so it's like, oh,
you
well,
like only these.
You clearly like Deadmau5 so much. Also, Bangarang, again. It is still my favorite thing. Like, Bangarang was so, like, such a big hit at the time. Like, that... it became an inside joke with my friends, so at least it was popular enough that around school and stuff, we heard it a lot.
Oh, he fully blocked
but
all the fire damage.
It became this inside joke that we couldn't escape from the Bangarang, and then freaking Sonic Boom, its advertisement, is freaking Bangarang, and I was like, oh my god. I was like, David, you gotta see this! He's like, no way. And that was like after
the
song hit.
Strafe and wig out the AI into overturning,
yeah.
So they can't hit me.
That was also after
the
song had been out for at least a year, you know? For pop charts, that's pretty long. That's an old song.
Although I do miss the skeletons having their heads start to fall off and then they catch them. They can't do that now that they have a shield.
That does
so
sound
at least the
kind
sword
of funny
has
and awesome.
More dumb tail in it. Empty.
Slowly. Oh wait, I can run.
Skills on the ground.
Okay, Solaire's chilling. Ah, no. I want my. Are you gonna be good? Are you gonna let me get my shit? Are you gonna let me?
Yeah, some people try to go around the long way. That's never fun. To get that shield. Always take the shortest
route.
Okay,
we at least have it back.
Saves you taking a lot of damage.
I'm not out of bonfire. Solaire. Do you have anything else? Solaire.
And in this one, they no longer just call it the bow, it's the large bow.
I will stay behind to gaze at the sun. The sun is a wondrous body.
Still don't have an aiming reticle.
Father. If only I could
so
be
you
kind of
just have to
incandescent.
Take a guess shot.
That's nice to know
set.
You have a sun fetish.
You just pull back and guarantee a hit.
Try stabbing him back. That's a beautiful. Yep, right there. Perfect.
Oh yeah, player hints are so nice.
Yeah. Of course, that's the best strategy against Solaire. Stab him in
what's
the back. Okay.
Nice.
So
what is it you're playing again?
So there's that one charred body, but do I just
before?
Like?
No.
I swear there was like fire that came from behind me. Like, there's all these dudes who are guarding,
so
and they're
like,
"Dude, you need to go this away." But well, there's that one bouncer dude, as I called him. I can go fight him. I don't think. This is me fighting against myself, saying this isn't a good idea.
And that's why you played him?
Was he... But he was up there last time, I thought.
Yes, I've heard of that one, but I
haven't fight him
it.
As much as you would like to. You gonna be a good dragon?
Oh.
Can I read this message? No? I don't wanna...
So that helped to kind of make you want to play it then?
But then there's... Vaguely remember being spoiled parts of this dragon. But that doesn't mean...
What's optional?
Out of my way! Phew! That was better.
Empty. Oh, that's just because
we
hit a wall on one side of this. With extra skeletons that you then have to fight.
Hey, jerk, why don't you get over here? I don't want to go over there. Because I know better. No, don't walk away from me. I'm over here.
Giant
me.
Swords.
No. Oh, I guess he's guarding. Checking the perimeter.
Yeah.
Well, I can't shoot them damn tail. I ain't got no bows. Ha! Ha! Ha!
When did Final Fantasy VII come out? Do you know? Okay, so this is still... Kingsfield 2 is still a year before Final Fantasy 7, then. Yeah, I forget. That's why I was asking.
Got it. Give me that. Is it better than what I have now? Because I doubt it. Actually, it is.
You don't want. Settings fucking with you,
No. No, it's. Strike.
Oh, yeah. Here, I'll look it up.
Heavily rusted but sturdy, providing a strong defense. Insufficient. Well, I wasn't trying to dual wield.
Okay, so Kingsfield was...
Dang it.
Kingsfield's win, too, were...
So it's one of the... Is this, like, one of those tower shields or something?
Yeah, January 31st. So, Kingsfield... So
Steady.
Final Fantasy VII, you know, had very...
Steady, I see an
graphics.
Enemy.
I find it sad that Kingsfield, with its character models, was better than Final Fantasy.
Oh, hey, rats, never mind. Oh my god, the poison.
Battle. They weren't that bad, but they still didn't
there
have as
go.
Much detail as
we
like,
got
the character. Like people were probably
yeah, I'm sure
this
is a great corner.
But like I get the
the
layout
gorgeous
and levels
feel
and stuff was kind
of
bad for this. But some of the enemies have some nice detail.
More gorgeous view. Is there an illusionary wall?
And for the time of 3D, like, especially with the massive jump between 7 and 8 graphic style, like, it kind of makes
doop,
when you
doop,
see 8's,
doop,
like,
doop,
graphics
doop,
and you see 7's,
doop, doop, doop,
it kind of makes you wonder what were they really fucking doing in that year it took between the two games.
Hi, brain.
Tactics, Vagrant Story, sure, Parasite Eve.
I was like, I know I saw something.
But those
but
all
I was just
graphics
I kept squeezing the camera
anyway.
Around. Hi! Don't want to deal with you.
Well, yeah, it wasn't supposed to be on the
that's
screen.
That's gotta Nintendo. Be. Oh god, I aggroed him. I'm dead. No, it's fine, man. Go enjoy your cupcakes.
And then something happened, I bet.
Go enjoy. No. I'm in deep shit. I'm in the deepest of the deepest. Oh crap. That was everything I had.
Instead of like a 32 meg.
Why did I not have the hollow bone?
500 meg disc.
Yeah, I wouldn't think I'm getting counter tower shields, because that sounds like a late game build, you know?
Wasn't the game also rushed?
This is what I get for not equipping. I wanted to run away and be like, well, at least I can raise my stats a little bit. Come back later. No. I had to die again. Okay, so I've been streaming for almost.
Yeah, it's just that's the biggest thing.
Wait,
for me
when did
like,
I start streaming? About
8
o'clock? So I've gone about 2 hours without a break. So that's it's
hard.
Probably best if I take a break for a few minutes. Stretch a bit. Try to dab the souls and run away.
It makes me think they were both being made at the same time because they come out within a year of each other, and a game
so,
like that doesn't
I'll
take
do that
a
then.
Year. It takes 2 or 3.
I reckon. Where's that on break? It's got to be more than 5 minutes, unfortunately. But I can stream for like at least one more hour.
7 was in development.
After this break, and then I think the tired will start hitting because it'll be 11 o'clock, so. Alright, be back in a few. Let me just finish up this blueberry bar. Yum yum.
Really? Well, yeah, I suppose because you'd have to understand 3.5 manual in order to play the damn game, so.
Oh, wait, I haven't put my headset back on yet. Whoopsie.
I actually preferred the manual that came
with
the game.
There.
I mean, it was a big book, but at least it explained shit. And then it came with like a hard picture of what every spell was for each class, not how they work. Because
that's a lot of souls at stake. I should be more patient, because, yeah.
It's like, here, read this before playing, and then you can play. Oh, it was in detail, huh?
Just to say.
Myst was interesting because I have an original copy of Myst. It came with a strategy guide in it for those who didn't want to be buggy yet.
Wow.
I just wanted to like explore around because I was like, I opened it up, I found it brand new at like Bookman. I opened it up and I'm like, wait, is this a fucking strategy guide? And sure enough, it's literal step by step how to complete the game and like a 40-page, like, strategy guide.
I just realized Myst would be a good way to honor my grandfather. He loved that game, apparently.
Most older people love Myst. For some weird reason. Even if they've never played it, they've heard of it.
Yeah. Like, that was one of the few times he's like, so, granddaughter, do you know what Myst is? I'm like, by name. I used to play it. Every now and again.
Well, now that you love your puzzle games, you should go and retry it. It's a great game if you like doing puzzles.
Do I like doing puzzles?
I was talking to Ro.
Okay, I was like, wait, what?
No, Kira hates puzzles.
Although, when I was in, like, middle school, and I was like, oh my gosh, I want to start doing YouTube Let's Plays, because this is when, like, PewDiePie had just started taking off a little more.
Wow, when you say that, I was like, I was in this level high school then.
I know. Oh no, this is late middle school, early high school.
Yeah, then it would have been, like, middle of my high school, but I didn't watch YouTube when I was in high school. I was too busy taking programming classes.
Well, that's a lot more exciting. This is also when, you know, Amnesia was popular, so... Everyone and their grandma had to do an Amnesia playthrough. But yeah, there's footage that, like, I was using a buggy version of Fraps, so, like, nothing recorded right, so
wait,
it wasn't worth keeping.
You're younger than
Is it?
You said Amnesia just now, didn't you?
Yeah, I thought...
Because Amnesia came out my first year of college.
No,
so
I thought you were a year ahead. You're a year ahead of me, so...
That makes no sense, because Amnesia came out my first year of college.
Let's...
2011.
I was a junior.
Yeah, you were saying late middle school.
Okay, my bad.
Like,
I had the mentality of late middle school, screw it. Yeah. Right, because if I couldn't play Halo until I was like 15, there's no chance in hell I could have snuck it to my parents. Hey, I want to play this really screwed up game.
Also, wouldn't you have even then in between AI?
No. Well.
Or was that just your last 2 years of high school?
No, I was like I think that was my first year at. No, it had to be at least my second year. I remember which instructor I had, and. I was so frustrated because none of the audio was syncing to my Amnesia Let's Play. And he was confused. He thought I actually built, like, this hallway with a broom that I could interact with. And you can clearly tell I'm distracted because I have not attacked this guy at all. And I'm like, no, I'm just trying to record video game footage. And meh. Anyways. This is a long tangent. What I was getting at is, there's some really, like, unusable footage of some really crappy, like, one of those bottom-of-the-barrel, like, games you would buy for, like, $5. It was, like, a puzzle game or whatever, but I sucked at the puzzles, and apparently I had some interesting commentary while being frustrated.
So here's a question, Kieran. What are you doing in Starship Titanic?
Shit, I don't know, man. I just...
So you can make the bird slushy thing.
Oh, I don't want to make more Starling puree. Why did you remind me of the Starling puree? I hate you.
So I heard you were, like, mortified as a kid.
Well, yeah, I was, like, 4. And I was trying to understand this obscure-as-hell point-and-click adventure. And all of a sudden, I killed a bunch of birds.
And that's a solution to a puzzle.
Part of the solution. It's to help make the Titanic titillator. An amazing drink that really messes up the AI of the bartender. Because he's a robot. Everyone's a robot. So you need, like, Starling puree and, like,
oh.
Crap, what was another ingredient? I think you had to have chicken. But... The mail delivery robot really, really likes chicken, so he had to put mustard on it so that he wouldn't eat it and destroy the item.
Yeah,
no, other guy.
Starship Titanic is surprisingly similar to Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. That was a bit of trivia Karen and I learned about when we were Googling it.
Well, oh, it's in the same universe?
Yeah, it's in the same universe, because... Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy makes reference to the Starship Titanic.
But vaguely, and
but
then...
Starship Titanic, if you put in quotes and stuff from Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, it says you're confusing two universes.
Even though they're technically the same.
Even though they're in the same universe, but that's just because Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy deals with multiple universes.
Yeah, exactly.
That makes up their universes. That would be a fun one to play, though. Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, a text-based adventure game.
Was it? Okay. I was like, wait, there
it
was
had a text-based adventure game, and it was basically...
Shit, man. Rambling for
his... I think it was about 84 as well, because it came out around the same time Adventure, but it goes by another name. A Thousand Ways to Die, taking one step.
Damn it! I lost... No! Okay, now...
I was trying to show it as a project, because I was trying to build a text-based adventure
I definitely
project,
see why it will take Game Grumps,
like,
oh, eight episodes
to
do stuff in what should have taken 15 minutes, you know?
Anything.
Sorry, there was a time I, like, avidly watched their videos early
so
on,
to watch me
and that was the biggest complaint they got. They spent an entire episode not knowing what button to press while playing Sonic 06. Good time.
It's
15 minutes of them. And I'm like,
I
just spent God knows how much time
just
strafing around a stupid shield enemy here.
I
want
to go work on it more, but I have to rewrite it.
That sucks, dude. I lost so many souls.